Ever heard of the word extinct? That means completely wipe off a living organism from the land. The leftover is its remains in the form of bone or fossils. Statistically, about 5 billion of the living species ever habituated the Earth is extinct. We can only trace them or talk about their existence by some scientific evidences. Same goes with this aquatic living organism. This is Earthy Perks, with an episode to reveal all about the Chinese paddlefish that's no more alive on this Earth. According to the data timeline, the last of the Chinese paddlefish was seen alive in 2003, and since then, is declared extinct. Scientifically named as Cephalus gladius, these Chinese paddlefish, along with its close relatives, have been around for at least 200 million years. The species is said to be a tough one. It survived unimaginable changes and upheavals, such as the mass extinction that killed the dinosaurs and marine reptiles like plesiosaurs that it swam alongside. In its time, flowering plants evolved and came to populate the shores of its ancestral home, the Yangtze River. It also saw the Earth evolving and become all-way new in appearance with an increment of species and living organisms. Much later, bamboo came on the scene, and well after that, giant pandas. In the muddy waters of Yangtze, the paddlefish lived as if it had for eons, using its special sword-like snout to sense electrical activity to find prey, such as crustaceans and fish. But this tough organism couldn't make it through a world populated by humans. Scientists confirmed that the species had gone extinct, mainly due to overfishing and dam construction. Chinese paddlefish, reaching up to 23 feet in length, had a long sword-like rostrum, a snout-like structure packed with cells. It was thought by many to be the world's largest freshwater fish, weighing nearly half a ton. It had a long silver-gray body and a very large mouth. With poorly developed eyes, the fish fed with its eyes open. The species gradually declined over the last century. In the 1970s, 25 tons of paddlefish were harvested per year on average. This enormous bulk made them a popular target for fishermen and a welcome addition to dinner tables, including those of ancient Chinese emperors. Apart from overfishing, one thing that contributed to utmost was the construction of Gezeba Dam. Built on the main stem of the Yangtze, a little over 1,000 miles from the sea, this dam, which was constructed without a fish ladder or bypass, cut off the paddlefish from their only spawning grounds upstream. This migration route was further disrupted by the construction of the enormous Three Gorges Dam. Populations of the fish continued to dwindle after the 1981 dam construction. China listed the paddlefish as a protected species in 1989. Sightings of the fish continued in the 1990s. The fish had become functionally extinct by 1993, meaning there were not enough fish to meaningfully reproduce. In 2003, an adult Chinese paddlefish was accidentally captured near Yibin in south-central China. It was tagged, hoping to track its movements, but within hours, all signals from the tag were lost. It turned out to be the last of the species ever seen alive. In 2018 to 2019, scientists and researchers embarked on a basin-wide biological survey to locate any individuals remaining in the Yangtze. Using various types of nets, sonar, electrofishing gear, and other techniques to locate any representatives of the species. But this was too late, and all efforts gone in vain. Every living organism on this planet is a part of big or small picture in terms of conserving the biome and food webs. Rapid extinction of various species with unknown impacts on environment can lead us to lose the ones playing crucial roles to maintain the environment. This is Earthy Perks, signing off with a public service message. Live and let live. Otherwise, we are going to destruct our own planet.